Hey folks, this is Vineet from the urbanastronomer.com. So in this video, I wanted to just go through how we can make an animation of Jupiter's rotation. So this is pretty straightforward, but before doing this, it would actually help if you already know how to process planetary images from videos. And I have already covered that in an earlier video, so if you have not already checked it out, do check it out, and I will leave the link in the description and also as a video card if possible. So what you're seeing here is basically a list of videos of Jupiter, okay? And if you look at the date in which they were created. So I've copied the files over, so date modified actually shows the creation date on the camera. You can see that it's a list of videos from 518 till 548, so that's roughly half an hour, and it's like taken every 2 to 3 minutes. So you can see about 3 minute interval and so on, 2-3 minutes between the videos. So this is basically what you need to do. So you actually need to capture a videos of Jupiter one after the other with short intervals between each, and you will end up with this kind of data. And after this, obviously, it is just image processing each of these files into individual images, and then using those images to form the final animation. It's as simple as that. So let's actually do it. So this, if you see, is actually not very good data. So let me just share this. We can hardly see the Jupiter over here, but we can actually fix that using pip. So you can see Jupiter over here, it's pretty faint. But obviously your data capture might be much better than maybe you are using SharpCap or some other way. What I do is to just use my mirrorless camera to pick it up directly, and there are certain limitations with that way in which I capture the data. In any case, I think if you already capture images of planets, you should be able to do an animation of Jupiter very easily. So once you bring up pip, we will add the image files. I will select all the movie files over here. You can see it is listed all of the movies in order that we have selected it. Now the next step is obviously to go into processing options, and as you could see, the image file was very dim in my case. I'm just going to bump up. It's really high, and this is not something most of you will need to do, but I am doing it because my data is bad. So you can see that Jupiter is really lighting up in this image now, and you can even see the bands, and it looks really bad quality, but that's fine because once we run it through AutoStacker, we will end up with a good image. As always, I'll select object planetary. I'll enable object detection. You can detect this tool if you want, so it will show you Jupiter in red over here. I'm not really going to try and get the moons in this one, because it's, I think, going to be pointless. So I'm just going to center the object in the frame and enable cropping. I think this image should come up nicely within a 280 by 280 width and height. Specifically for my case, so you can see it is the whole of the planet is coming up within this. So it's usually a good habit to do the cropping. Of course, try to include the moons. So you might want to, if you wanted to include the moons here, you might put this as 1000, and then it would show the moons if the data was good. But I'm just going to put it at 280 by 280. Because the ABI files are large, so obviously it's a good thing to just try and crop it down to what you really want. You can also resize, but I'm not going to do that as of now. Then we will check the output options, and it should be an ABI so that it can go in as an input into AutoStacker. Then I'm going to click start processing, and it will process each of these individual files into AVI files. Okay, so now we are done with the pre-processing of these files generating the AVI files. So just let's take a look at the pre-processed files. Okay. So it has created a new folder like pip. This is based on your pip settings. So if I go inside, I can see the list of AVI files, and you can see it is brighter. Than the original data that I had, and so this should work better with AutoStackPlot. So one more thing I wanted to show was the size of these files. So if you see, this is actually 632 MB and 377 MB. It depends on the length, of course. 547, 628, 546 MB. If you're looking at the size over here, 482, and so on. So this is why we need to actually crop the AVI as much as possible when we are generating it. Otherwise, we will end up with huge, gigantic files, and it will fill up the file system in no time. So, also after generating the final image, final animation, maybe you might want to consider deleting the AVIs. Otherwise, you'll end up filling up your system pretty fast. Okay, so let's bring up AutoStackPlot now, and what I will do is I'll open all of the AVI files together as a batch. Okay. So open it. And this is a planet. And I'll leave this on Picted 4. Local is fine, and we will go ahead and analyze. So this is the first frame of the first file. I'm just going to select a specific frame that I prefer. So let's just go with this one, and I would keep the size of the alignment point a little larger. Because that seems to work better for a planet like Jupiter, or at least with the kind of data set that I have had till now. Obviously, we need to experiment and see if that changes, but basically around 100, 104, or you can adjust the number if you want. But I'm just going to put my points around the layers like that, and I think we should be done. So go ahead and stack that. I have set the frame percentages to stack at 60%. Of course, this you can play around. You can see the quality graph over here, and I'm just going to go with 60. Okay. And I have set a normalized stack at 75%, and to generate a sharpened file as well. These are like you don't need to if you are going further. Process a registax, but you know, I'm just going to leave it there. There's also RGB align, which I will select for this planet. If you remember in the Venus processing video I did earlier, the RGB select was unselected here, and I opted to do the RGB align in registax. But in case of Jupiter, since we're doing an animation, I'm going to leave it on here, and then I'm just going to stack, and it will not just stack the first file, but it'll stack all the AVI files, which I'm fine with, so I'm going to go ahead and stack it. As this is stacking, it will actually start generating the files as well. So let's take a look at, so you can see that the files have started generating. So we can examine the images and then stop and restart in case, you know, we find some issues. You can see this is the output of the AutoStackPlot, and then there is a sharpened image as well from AutoStackPlot. Actually, don't use this one, but just gives a rough idea of what we can expect with the output. This is the output, then there's the sharpened you just move through the file, you can already start seeing that slight movement in the bands. That is just between, like, I think maybe in about 10 minutes, this much of movement can be seen. Jupiter is actually a great planet for doing animations because it is, the rotation is so fast that within 10 hours the planet would have completed one rotation. So in span of a night we could actually do a complete rotation video, which is actually in the on the books for me sometime in the future. And let's see if it happens. So we had actually done with the stacking as of now, and the next step would be to enhance each of the images in Registax. So now we will use Registax to finer enhance the images that we generated with AutoStackCut. I actually don't want the converted files, I only want the unsharpened files. So I'm just going to open the first one. Okay. And this is how it looks. And you can see these available schemes over here. So if I select that, I actually have some settings which are already saved. Now everything may not work, like, you know, one setting might not work across multiple data collections, but then I had saved this this one earlier. So what you can do is you can play with the first image that you have, and then based on that you can decide what you want to try and use. So you can see that these different settings are going to give me different outputs. Okay, so let's just take one of these right now. And okay, so this is again basic planetary processing, so you might have a preferred way in which you try to process your images. But so once we have some setting that we like, it's a good idea to save it as a scheme over here, so that every time that you load an image, you can just easily load that setting back and then use that. Okay, so let's go with this Jupiter one which I had saved earlier. So I'm using linked wavelets, Gaussian, and denoise of 25.25, sharpen of 0.280, and then an additional layer of minus 0.6 and 0.100, which had worked out fine for me. So one key thing that you need to do with actually any planet, but specifically with Jupiter, it will make it look much better, is if you use the RGB balance and you click on auto balance, and you can see that it clears up that the color a lot better, right? So then I'm just going to save this image and let it be a PNG or TIFF, it is up to you. I'm just going to save this as one. And I'll just select the next one, which is this one. This is the sharpened image, I'm skipping that because these both are the same piece. So I'll select this and I'll load Jupiter 1. I'll do an auto balance, save image 2. And then I'll repeat this basically for all the images. Okay, so now we are done with actually processing with Registax, and we have generated 15 images. So here we can see the 15 frames that we generated by processing further in Registax. These are going to be the final frames that we will be using in the rotation animation. Okay, so let's bring up PIP again and add the image files. I'm going to add all 15 of them. I'm going to click shift and then just select all 15 files. If it's join mode has been selected, that is fine, we can ignore that. So we can see all the 15 files over here. Okay. Now when we go to processing options, Now suppose we want to create a 500 by 500 animation, and just let's say test. If you are, when we're looking at the output frame here, we can see this nasty little box here, which has come because of the processing that we have done. So the edge of the frame that we originally had, it's kind of getting colored like this. So what we can do to get rid of this is we can do a smaller cut and then do a resize of the frame to a larger frame. So this is something I also do with where I'm capturing a time lapse of an eclipse or something like that, and I need to trim the edges or do some resize. PIP is a very good tool for that also. Okay, so here what we will do is I will set it to 250 by 250 and I'll just test it. Actually, I will also set the object detection on so that it is centered in that. Okay, let's test it. And you can see that unwanted color is gone. So this processing should be pretty quick. So let me go back to PIP. And then output options, I'm going to select PNG again because we want the individual frames. And I'm going to do processing and start processing. So it has generated a new set of files, which will become frames of the animation. So let's come back to PIP again, and I'm going to remove all the image files and add the new set, which we generated here. In processing options, I will set the cropping section dimensions to the animation dimension that I want. So if I'll set it to 500 500, and let's test, and this is going to be the final dimension that we will have. So there are some additional things to do here now that we are going to generate the animation. So we will set the output. So we can either select an animated GIF or we can go with an AVI. So let's go with an AVI, and you can see, so in animated GIF, there are different options here with which you can select the parameters that you want for the GIF. For example, the frame rate and things like that. I'm just going to go with an AVI. So because I can then convert that into an MP4 later for upload and things like that. So here I'm just going to say use, so this is not applicable anyways because you're using images. The frame rate that we need to use, so I'm just going to use this as 10. So this will be a 1.5 second one way animation. So because we have 15 frames, so it will take 1 second to show 10 frames, and then the rest five frames will be shown in the rest one half second. And when we go to the animations options now, we can see there are different options here. In forward play, play all frames in forward order. Okay, pause final frame for each. I'm not looking at pausing it, so that's, I'll leave that. Then reverse play, so after forward play we will also do a reverse play. Play all the frames in reverse order after forward play. So we will select this. Then complete sequence repeat, so we will repeat the sequence for all frames in the sequence. So let's repeat the whole thing for number of complete sequence repeats. Let's repeat it for five times. Okay, and in the last sequence that it plays, don't repeat the reverse play. So that means we will end with the actual end of the original, like the 15th frame. So we will select it in this way, and the output option we already selected, and then we will do processing. Let's generate the new file. Okay, so this is generated as an AVI. So here we can see the animation that we just made just now. Okay, so I think that's it. Please do subscribe, share, like, comment on all of that stuff. I really appreciate it, and thanks a lot for watching.